G'day guys, and today I want to ramble a bit about climate change. Now, just to make my position very clear to anyone who is already furiously scrabbling to write themselves a comment, I am the world's ultimate fence sitter in terms of the topic of climate change. I do not know if climate change is real, if climate change is anthropogenic, or if it's a natural process. I don't know. I haven't looked into it, mainly because the solutions that I'm seeing proposed by the environmentalist movement are not going to work based on their own guidelines of what's going wrong. And we're going to talk about one of those things today. So when you chat to people or read articles about climate change and environmentalism and that sort of thing, you'll often get a section of history, you know, when did climate change start? When did it start becoming a problem and this sort of thing? And what has occurred in some of these things I've read and what people have said to me is people believe that climate change, the human anthropogenic impact on the climate around the world, to a deleterious effect, started with the Industrial Revolution back in 1760, continuing onwards to 1840 and only getting worse over time. Now, this is a huge problem. I don't think people quite grasp the idea of how terrible and horrible this will be and what we're going to have to do if this is the case. So what you've got to picture, guys, is with the start of the Industrial Revolution, you have some modern or semi-modern or proto-modern, we'll say, industrial processes beginning to start up in parts of Europe and the US of A. And what you're trying to tell me when you tell me that climate change started with the Industrial Revolution is that this small amount of industry, of course, the industry kicked off in a big way. There was a lot more industry than there was before. But this small amount of industry, relative to what we have today, is sufficient enough to cause a potentially deleterious and permanent effect on the Earth's climate. If you're going to go ahead and say that, well, we obviously have a huge problem with the amount of industry we have today, especially coming out of countries like China and India. And obviously, if we want to reverse climate change or stop climate change, what we'd need to do is get to pre-industrial revolution levels of emissions. And that's a huge problem. Now, why do I say this? Because the Earth's population has exploded, especially in the third world countries in places like Africa, due to the Industrial Revolution, because of things like industrial farming. The production of fertilizers, cheap fertilizers that can be used to grow crops, is obviously an industrial process. It requires machines, industry, and pollution, and that sort of stuff. And it is this widespread access to fertilizers that has allowed the earth to provide a much more bountiful harvest of food, which in turn supports a larger human population. So we have this huge problem if we need to get back to pre-industrial levels of emissions, because either technology needs to get so efficient and so non-wasteful and non-harmful and non-emittive to the environment that we can, you know, have this massive level in industry and have this larger population on Earth without deleting the climate, or we need to rapidly and terribly, dramatically reduce this population of humans on Earth, because it's simply, we can't have both. If it is the case that is the climate change started with the Industrial Revolution, and obviously we have a subsequent population growth from that, we can't have pre-industrial revolution levels of industry and 7 billion humans on the planet. It just can't coexist. The population of humans on this planet is sustained by industry. It is sustained by things such as the industrial production of fertilizers, as we said, and modern farming practices which require vehicles and fuel and emissions and all this stuff. We are, you know, growing and sustaining the human population at the cost of the earth, as these people would say. So when people come up to me and say, or link to me and say things like, look, this is when climate change started, I have to say, are you advocating for the mass slaughter of people? Should we just nuke the entirety of Africa and Asia? You know, there is that little circle around the Asia, India, Pacific region. There are more people inside that circle than there are outside, and it covers, you know, not that much of the Earth's surface. Are you advocating that we just nuke all those people back to the Stone Age, quarantine off the area so the radiation doesn't get to us, and, you know, suddenly we have 4 billion less people who need industry and farming practices and that sort of thing? And that's just saved a lot of emissions. So if you're advocating this idea that climate change started with the Industrial Revolution, you do have to get serious about the wholesale slaughter, or at least sterilization, of hundreds of millions of people, because that's the only way we're going to get back to pre-industrial levels of emissions. Thanks all for sticking around, and have a good one.